this is a Togi Demon again. I'm just doing a bit of an update on an app I reviewed a few days ago called File Audio. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because I've come across a lot of my CDs that are older CDs that you just can't find the album artwork or the CD cover or, you know, the exact one that you want, basically. So I've found in my CD collection a CD that's very old. It's called Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker. It's the complete ballet score, so it's a two-disc set. And basically, I know for a fact you can't find the cover for this. I've tried everywhere to find the cover and I can't find it. So I'll just show you what you can do. You'll need a scanner, copy a printer. Basically, you need to have a scanner. And you can add it now before you start the program. So make sure it's on. So I'll just stick the Tchaikovsky CD in. Just wait for File Audio to pick it up. It doesn't take very long usually, as I showed you last time. There we go. Now it has found the exact database file for it, so that's the exact one. So there we go, Tchaikovsky Nutcracker. Now it's disc 1 of 2, so that's the other thing you can do. If it's 2 discs, change it from disc 1 of 2. As I said, it says there anyway, it's disc 1. Just there. Okay. Now, gapless, again, you need to click that because it's classical and it is gapless. Now, find the album cover. Loads and loads. I mean, there are loads and loads of Tchaikovsky Nutcracker album covers I could pick from, but I want the exact one, and I'm sure you would as well. So you go back, you take out the front cover of your CD and put it in your scanner, make sure it's the right way around, and you click capture. Now it's picked up my DeskJet printer, HP DeskJet. You click scan. The scanner's warming up, as you can probably hear. This is one of the brilliant features of File Audio that I missed out last time. It is so quick and so easy. And what it does is it sizes, you can click there, detect separate items. If you click there, and it will do, it's actually done it wrong there because I didn't click detect separate items. So it will only show that tiny little bit there and not the top bit. As you see there, look, it hasn't picked it up. Right, so if I go back to capture, click detect separate items and then scan again, hopefully it will detect the whole thing. I have to wait and see. No, it's done it again. For some reason, it only picks up the bottom. Unfortunately, you can't change it in this program. But if you're happy with just that bit at the bottom there, then you can go ahead and do it. So I'm happy with that. That's no problem for me. So I will now click rip. And wait. the encoding if you need to stop whatever and do something else on the computer. Or you can click do not show completed items, which, as you'll see, once I click this, they're gone. That's still encoding at the moment. That's just encoding the cover. But the cover's there, but for some reason, always on the last track, it takes a while. There we go, it's there. Now go back to the device. Now, just one more thing. Something that is quite useful again. I'll put the CD back in. Okay. Now, before, it obviously picked up all the correct information, but if for some reason there's something you want to change, now I've picked it up, so I'll pick it up again there. Now, album artist. Well, really, yes, it's Tchaikovsky, but if you want to have the composer, sorry, not the composer, the conductor, it's the Charles Macarras. You could change that. So you just literally go back and change it to Sir Charles. How do you spell his name? S. Okay, now as you've changed it there, it's changed every track artist. You don't have to do them individually. The other thing here is it picked up Christmas as the genre. Well, it is because it's a Christmas ballet, but I should have clicked classical. So you can click classical. You can then capture your cover again if you want to, basically. But as I say, File Audio, one of the best file rippers out there. Sorry, CD rippers out there. Basically because... I'll just go back. One moment. For some reason I am... Right. Simply because you have this choice if you go into preferences, as I showed last time, is that you can basically rip one CD into MPEG AAC, MPEG 4 AAC, Apple Lossless, OGG Vorbis, FLAC, MP3, which I do, AIF, and WAVE, which is the raw data, basically. So it's the exact CD. Now, you can click every single one of those, and it will basically record all of them. Well, encode all of them. Okay. Now let me take those off because I don't want that to happen when I go back on it. Again, as I said on mine, I have the presets on insane because that's constant bit rate, which I like. I don't like the variable bit rates. And just tell you a little bit of an explanation there. It says explain this preset. And it says a preset insane, 320 kilobytes. Constant bitrate, low maximum quality. I prefer that. Okay, so that's just the end of that. All it basically was to show you how you can scan your artwork of cover, CD cover artwork, and then embed it into all the tracks as you rip the CD. Okay, thank you for watching.